Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to solve LeetCode problem 389, find the difference. This is one of the frequently asked questions by Google. So let's just first go through the description and we will see how we are going to solve this question. So as you guys like, you are given two strings S and T. String T is generated by random shuffling string S, and then add one more letter at random position. Return the letter that was added to T. So they have given a few examples. So let's take one example here. So for example, like as you can see, if we have been given a string S and string T, right? So string and S and string T can be in. So what they have said is string S is shuffled and then a random character is added, right? So in this example, this random character is added, this one, right? E, because as you can see, ABCD and ABCD both are common here. So we have to just find the random character and we have to return that random character as our answer, right? So for example, let's take one other example here. So let's say we have two strings. First string is A, B, C, D, and the second string is B, D, A, E, and C, right? So this is the second string. So what we are going to do to solve this problem is we are going to convert these both strings into array, right? So we will convert this using the toArray method of string class. So we will get an array of both strings, and then we are going to sort the characters in the array, right? So if we sort the first string, our first array now, then we will get like A, B, C, and D, right? After sorting. So this is position 0, 1, 2, and 3, right? And then we will sort this another array also. So after sorting this array, we will again get A, B, C, D, and E, right? And the positions will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 here, right? So after we have sorted the array, we will go and iterate through this string, right? First string. From 0 to n, right, where 0 to 3, and we will always compare the character, this character, with the other string, other string character, right, like sorted array character. So let's say we started comparing. So here also A, here also A. So as long as they are same, we will continue. So here we go and we find B here. So here also we find B. Then we will continue, here we find C, here also we find C, then we will continue, here we find D, then here we find D, right? So we have not found you know, the new character that is added yet. So at this time, at this point, our I basically is equal to 3, right? And what we will do at the end, we will just return this this is, let's say this is called as S array and this is called as T array, right? So we will just return the length of S array plus 1. So length of X array actually we will return, which is 4, right? 0, 1, 2, 3 means total length is 4 basically for S array. So that position we will return as the newly added character of this T array. So as you can see, T of 4 is this character that is added newly, and that one we will return as our answer, right? And in case if we find any difference when we are comparing, then at that time we will just return the difference directly. If we don't find until end, we will just return the length of the first array, right? T of length of the first array, which is T of 4, which is E. So that is what the approach we are going to follow to solve the problem. So let's just look into the implementation quickly. So first we have created S array by using two char array method of string, and then T array using the two char array on string of T, and then we have sorted both the arrays here, right? So sorting will be here, sorting is n log n, right? The time complexity for both n log n. And then we are going to iterate this array 0 to the length of the string s, right? And we will always, when we are iterating, we will compare that the ith position of s array and ith position of t array, if they don't match, then we will just return the ith position of t array, right? Because that will be the newly added element. If that does not happen during the for loop anytime, which means that we did not find the newly character added that we have seen in this case, right? We are finished with the string, but we never find any newly character added here because this string and this string is same. So in that case, as we discuss, you know, we will just return t array of s dot length, because the character that is newly added must be the last end character of this t, basically, right? So that's what we will add here, like we will return. So let us, you know, run a couple of examples here just to make sure that it's working fine. So ABCD and ABCDE is the one that is given to us. So let's create our own example. So ABCD, and then the second string, we will just take the our string that we said, BDAEC. And let's take the example they have given, this second one empty, and then the other string is y. And let's take another example that is they have given, it's the example 3 here, so a and aa, and let's just run this on all these examples. Expected t to have 5 or less, size got 6. Oh yeah, here we have one extra character added, so by mistake. So as you see, we are getting correct result. So we'll just submit our solution now. So our solution got accepted with 63%, 2 ms faster, and 70% better on memory usage, which is decent. So the time complexity for this solution will be more prominent, time will be sorting, right, which is n log n, because this one is just going to take n, where n is number of characters in string s. So you can say the time complexity will be n log n for this algorithm. And space complexity is, we are creating this sr and tr from string s, so that will be like you know, you can say if the string has n characters, then the time, like the array will have n characters, so that is the space that we have used. So that's how you can solve find the difference. This is one of the frequently asked questions at Google, so make sure you understand this and practice this solution. You might be knowing that I often create lead code videos for Java J2E solutions, as well as if you are preparing for Java interviews, I create videos for to help Java interviews, you know, telephonic interviews or in-person interviews. So there are a couple of playlists I already added there on my channel. Please check it out. They discuss a lot of different programming concepts like BFS, DFS, dynamic programming, as well as the Java data structures like HashMap, TreeMap, HashSet, linked list. So check it out, you know, there are a lot of good examples. And please subscribe to the channel, because, you know, subscription to the channel can help reach to more people like you who are preparing for interviews. So please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button if you like this video. Thanks for watching.